Hi there, Joseph Kerr, instructional designer here at Emporia State University. Wouldn't it be awesome if your students could go look at your Blackboard page and they see a picture and they're like, "All right, that's kind of cool," but then when they hover above it, they see some pretty interesting stuff, like a quote from somebody that's tied with the picture. Oh, hey, that looks interesting. That seems pretty cool and interactive. They've got websites they can visit pretty easily based off of the picture. They've got a chat discussion they can join on this link. And over here, you've got videos that actually pop up inside your picture on Blackboard.
Passengers on the city bus lines.
That's pretty cool. And it's really, really easy to do. So you can make your interactive image at thinglink.com because it's a bunch of things linked to a picture. If you don't want to make your own, they have a lot on here that you can do a search. It's really a lot like Pinterest as far as the format goes. One thing I saw on here is a map. So you could have this as a really cool thing to do for geography or some other kind of class that would involve maps. So you can put things wherever you want them to live on it. I saw another cool one that this is, I think, from a middle school, which is pretty cool because it kind of allows people to look at the inside of your school without actually going in. You can kind of show them a path of your wonderful dream for your school or whatever you want to do. So there's a lot that you can do with it as far as any type of interactivity goes. But to start on your own, you can join now if you haven't already. You fill out the information there, make an account. Otherwise, you can just log in. Now, when you log in, you just click Create, and it's really simple. Just pick an image. We're going to go with Beard Hat. It uploads it. And when it's loaded, it pops up this page. So we make our image interactive by adding tags. So we just click anywhere on it. We can pick our icon. And we can link to something. So let's say people want to know the instructions for making this. So I can go to this website. I can copy, paste, say, how to make this. Click somewhere else. Let's say people want to be able to find more ideas. We paste this and say more ideas. Click somewhere else for the academics out there. We want them to learn a little bit about the history of crochet, so we can copy this link to a history of crochet. Pick our icon. Save. Now, for the hipsters out there who want to stay up to date on the latest and greatest in crochet, they might want to follow it on Twitter. So, anybody who tweets something about crochet and puts hashtag crochet, what up, is able to be found really easily through our interactive image. So, you search hashtag crochet, so you copy that link, and we can pick a Twitter icon. For the real beginners, they might want a more in-depth tutorial, so we can find a YouTube video on crochet for beginners. Copy that link. And let's pick a play icon. And finally, when you're doing this, you might want some exciting crochet music. And so the site SoundCloud.com. I just searched crochet and actually got some results. Now, with this, you want to make sure you listen to a whole song because earlier I looked at this one and I thought, man, that's a really good song because this guy sings about his grandma crocheting for some kids and it's wonderful. Except right around here, there's a semi-dirty word. So you want to make sure you preview the whole song before you have students listen to it. So we'll go with this one. So we can click share. We copy this link. And we can have some crochet music now with a festive hat. All right, so these options here. If for your class you want your students to be able to access this, but you don't really need the public to be able to look at your image and interact with it, then you can click to make it unlisted. So only the people who you've given the link to or who someone else has given the link to is able to access it. So this is what you could put on your Blackboard page if that's what you want. If you want anybody to look at it, that's fine. Another option is to allow anyone to edit it. And I think this is a really cool idea for almost like a discussion board, basically, where you have students posting their own sets of information to it. And so it's kind of maybe something you want to try. Put a title in here, Beard Hat, and save. All right, so now what do you do with this? The link is up here. So you can copy this, or off to the side, you can go back in and edit it if you need to. This is kind of to add it to your favorites. To share it, this is a link that also you can just copy this and add it inside Blackboard, or share these other ways. And another option is to embed it, which I would recommend for Blackboard. So you can just copy this to the clipboard, and it's copied all this code. Now in Blackboard, you can add your item. And this is where you could just copy the link if you wanted to do that, but since we've copied the embed code, we can just go here. This is the icon to hit, and we paste, and you don't have to know what any of it means. You just tell it to submit, and now we have Beard Hat. So, an extremely easy, simple tool that can do a whole lot. I think there's a lot of potential with this. So, if you use this, you have one of these things you build, let me know. Tell me how you used it. Show me the link. I can tell other people, like, hey, this person had a lot of success with it. So that'll help everybody out. Give it a try, thinglink.com, and let me know how it turns out.